السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Am I audible for everyone? I need your interaction, please.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today we are going to a new module, which is the maternal medicine or the medical disorders with pregnancy. This module is very large module. You can expect any scenario. You can expect any case. But still, there are repeated recalls in each exam. We will discuss these recalls. And at the beginning, we are going to start with the maternal medicine template that can help you in any possible scenario, whatever you have seen it before in recall or you didn't see it. We will have the fixed points you have to mention in each scenario. If you manage to remember this point, even if you didn't see the scenario before, still you can go through the station smoothly. So close your mics, all please. All of you, close your mics. So, what are the possible scenarios in this module? In the last two modules, I mentioned what are the common recalls, but here I cannot mention because it's too much. So, any medical disorder is a possible scenario. Whatever you know or you don't know the scenario, relax and don't panic. Stick to the template. Go step by step. You can manage and you can have at least borderline in the station, but you will not fail if you stick to the template. So what is the maternal medicine template? As usual, you will start by the communication. So introduction. And as usual, in the 2 minutes reading, you will decide if you are going to enter the booth with a smile, if it is a happy scenario, or with a neutral expression, because there are some scenarios that you will tell the patient bad news. You are going to tell her that she is not fit for pregnancy and the safest way for her to go for termination. So 2 minutes, you will decide if you are going to go inside smiling or with a neutral expression. Then the rapport. Are you going to tell the patient, nice to meet you? Or you will just say, how are you doing today? If it is a difficult or if it is a sad scenario. So these points will make a difference in your introduction and in your communication with the patient. Introducing yourself by name and role, and confirming the patient name and age. Then make a good rapport with the patient, then mention the aim of the consultation. The aim of the consultation, the patient is coming because she is pregnant or she is looking for pregnancy. So this is the first aim. The second aim of the consultation will be the medical disorder that she has and she's coming to discuss it today. Ice, break the ice. As I told you in the previous two times, it's not acceptable to start the station without asking the patient about her concerns and expectations. Try to explore the expectations and the concerns of the patient or the role player, because she will guide you to the main purpose of the station or the core of the station, as we mentioned before. So please, please, always ask the patient about her concerns and expectation or what she is expecting from today's consultation. The agenda. Again, the agenda will save you if you didn't manage to finish in time. So the agenda is very important. You are going to tell the examiner what, if you have time during the station, what you are going to do. You will take some information from the patient to know more about her. If needed, you will do examination in presence of chaperone after the patient consent, and you may order some more tests and scans. Then you will discuss all the open options in her case, and you will involve the consultant in the management plan. You will write back to the GP and you will give her patient information leaflet and the contact numbers and support groups. This is the agenda, and you have to mention it in each scenario according to the candidate instructions. After the agenda, you will start taking the history. And again, please, the history, 3 or 4 minutes maximum. 3 or 4 minutes maximum. Please stick to this. During the practice today, you will see the alarm in front of you. So take care, no more than 4 minutes. Examination in cases needed after her consent in presence of chaperone and the reliable investigations. Then you are going to explore the options in each case, involve the consultant and arrange another appointment, patient information leaflet and write back to the GP or the midwife. And if you are going to inform the patient that this pregnancy needs a termination, this is this will have a psychological impact on the patient. So in this case, offer counselor, please, and support groups. The last two modules, we made a list of some agencies, and today we will add more agencies. So during the exam, if you mention it, you are telling the examiner or you are telling them that I know what is the system in UK. This will be in the communication of the with the patient and the families. What about communication with colleagues in any station? Please don't forget to mention the multidisciplinary team. Your care will be under consultant lead care by a multidisciplinary team, including 1, 2, and 3. So this is a fixed sentence that you have to start your management plan in each medical disorder with consultant lead unit under care of multidisciplinary team. The consultant has to be mentioned. You have to mention the consultant somewhere during the discussion. And writing back to the GP or the midwife is also considered as a communication with colleague. So if you find the communication with colleague in the domains you will be tested in, this is a very easy part to get a mark, to get a bus mark, if you mention multidisciplinary team consultant or write back to the GP or the midwife. So it is not acceptable at all in these case scenarios to miss the communication with colleagues. Of course, the endocrinologist, if she's diabetic, if she has Graves' disease, the medical, maternal, or the internal medicine, if she has hypertensive, so the related specialty according to the scenario. The problem, the usual problem of all candidates is the information gathering or the history taking. It is the time-wasting part in all domains. It is 1 out of 4 domains as we decided in the previous times. So please don't waste all the time of the station only taking the history. After the history, you need to ask for examination and investigation and to explain the patient her ongoing plan. So please, again, the history, 3 to 4 minutes maximum. What is the difference in the template of the maternal medicine? The difference here that the medical history will be the presenting history. You are going to analyze the presenting history here, which will be the medical history. So now you saved some time because you are not going to discuss any more presenting, any more medical history after presenting history here. So how you are going to discuss? Please start with open questions, as we decided before. Always in each part of the history, start with an open question. The role player will give you a brief about her case. So from the role player answer, you can decide what's next or how you are going to build up your plan. In each complaint, you need to know when was the onset, the course, and the duration of the disease. Targeted questions, please. If you kept asking unnecessary questions, you will lose the time and you will lose the station. fixed questions in each medical disorder if the patient has a regular follow-up with their specialist and when was the last visit. And if there is any special advice from the specialist regarding her pregnancy and her ongoing medications. If she had any hospital admission because of her condition. And what are the current medication she is taking and if these medications are safe with pregnancy or no, and you will decide from here if you are going to immediately transfer her to her specialist to change these medications or no. Don't go at the end and ask if she has any other medical condition, ask it here. Now we are analyzing one medical condition, by the end, ask, do you have any other medical conditions? Are you in any other drugs? Is there is any drug allergy? So all has to be mentioned here in the presenting history. And if you have a genetic condition or hereditary condition, don't forget to ask about the partner condition too, because this will make a difference in the management plan. So this is the presenting history. These are fixed questions in the presenting history of any medical disorder. If you manage to mention it all, you can get the targeted information needed from the patient. Please, please start with an open question. Again, the gyne history, open question. Can you tell me more about your periods? The obstetric history, if she was pregnant before and if she has the same condition in the previous pregnancy and what was the outcome of the previous babies. The surgical history, simply any surgery before, no need for tummy pelvis or down blow, any surgery before, because here is the point that I mentioned to you before. The patient here may have a heart surgery. So heart surgery is a surgery in the chest, not in the tummy or pelvis or down below. And this is a very reliable question here. After the surgical history, the family history, especially in genetic or hereditary conditions, and the social history, the smoking, the alcohol and recreational drugs, and safety and support at home and the job the patient is doing, and finally the mental history. Previously, the mental history has to be asked only in the booking visit and in the postpartum, but in the COVID guidelines now they are recommending to ask about the mental history in all cases. But if you feel that it will be related to the case, you can ask here about the four woolly questions. Coming to the applied clinical knowledge domain, actually, this will depend on the scenario. So we will start with examination and investigation. If needed, examination in face-to-face examination, you will tell the patient, I need to examine you in presence of chaperone. If you are going for online examination, and examination is required to tell the patient that we may need to arrange another appointment when you will be able to come in for examination. Just tell the patient that you need to examine here, but when she will be available in the clinic, because you know now that you are on a video call consultation. Explaining the diagnosis. Sometimes you will face a situation in the exam when you don't know anything about the syndrome. For example, Charcot-Marie tooth. It may be the first time when you face the scenario. It will be written some information about the syndrome in the candidate instruction, but if you don't know anything about the condition or about the syndrome, ask the patient. So, for example, Emma, can you tell me what you know exactly about your condition? At this point, the role player may give you some information about the case so you can decide how you are going to manage here. This question will be very important if you don't know anything about the medical disorder or if you are not familiar with the scenario. So please always start. Can you tell me what you know exactly about your condition? And then, yes, exactly. And continue your consultation. Continuation will be the prognosis of the condition will be with pregnancy. The prognosis means the effect of the condition on pregnancy and the effect of pregnancy on the condition. So in each medical disorder, you have to tell the patient what is the effect of pregnancy on her medical disorder and what is the effect of the medical disorder on her pregnancy, either maternal or fetal effect. The management plan, the usual start in the management plan, reassure the patient if her medical disorder allows for safe pregnancy. Emma, first of all, I want to reassure you that with proper care, women with hypertension or diabetes, if controlled, they can have successful pregnancy and they can deliver a healthy child. So this is a good start. Then you will start to tell her the complication. But in some cases, if the condition is not controlled or if your condition is not allowing the pregnancy, and you will start mentioning the complication. So always start, Emma, I want to reassure you that with proper care, women with diabetes, if controlled, they can have successful pregnancy and they can have a healthy child. But in some cases, and you will start to mention the effect of pregnancy in the condition and the effect of the condition in pregnancy. Please, in the multidisciplinary team and consultant lead care, don't forget this point in any maternal medicine scenario. This is a safety point and point of communication with colleagues. In all medical disorders, the patient will need more frequent visits. And in the management plan, you are going to put in your mind that you will counsel the patient either for continuation of pregnancy and what she has to do, or termination if it is a danger for her life. This is the plan during pregnancy. Now, plan of delivery. You have to mention the timing, the recommended timing for delivery, and the recommended mode of delivery, and if there are any special precautions in your condition. Then postpartum, VTE risk assessment. If she's fit for breastfeeding or breastfeeding is contraindicated, what is the kind of contraception suitable in her case, especially if she got unplanned pregnancy because of the failure of the method she was using before? And specialist follow-up. She has a medical disorder, so you will give her recommendation here to continue her follow-up with her specialist. And the plans for future pregnancy, what she needs to do if she's planning for a future pregnancy. This means preconceptional counseling. If she needs to do IVF or BGD before the next pregnancy to avoid getting pregnant with a baby with any hereditary or genetic disorder. If the patient is not fit for pregnancy and he has a medical disorder that prevents her from getting pregnant, so you will offer her other options of having babies in genetic conditions and if there is contraindication to pregnancy. So what she needs to do? IVF and BGD, adoption and surrogacy. So this is the template of the maternal medicine module. If you stick to this point, means you cover all the points in any case scenario, and the clinical knowledge will play a mild role in your case. So whatever the scenario you will see in the maternal medicine, don't get panic, please. Just remember these points, how to introduce yourself, how to put an agenda, how to go through the history, and the management plan will be examination investigation, will be planned during pregnancy, during delivery, and postpartum, and other options. If the patient is not fit for pregnancy, then you will close the station with, if you manage to reach the time, close the station. The patient information leaflet, another appointment with the consultant, referral if needed, and contact numbers and support groups. Is that clear, everyone?